जय हिंद एवरीवन। आई सुवर्णा मुजुमदार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अजय कुमार गर्ग इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज, वेलकम्स यू ऑन अ लेक्चर ऑन मशीन साइकिल इन 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड कवर्ड अबाउट द आर्किटेक्चर पार्ट ऑफ 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मशीन साइकिल, दैट इज द ऑपरेशन ऑफ 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर, दैट व्हाट ऑल ऑपरेशन दिस मशीन 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर विल परफॉर्म। एंड द मशीन साइकिल इज द ड्यूरेशन और यू कैन से द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड बाय दिस माइक्रोप्रोसेसर टू परफॉर्म अ पर्टिकुलर टास्क, दैट इज द मशीन ऑपरेशन। सो दीज आर सम मशीन ऑपरेशंस that are going to be performed by 8085 microprocessor. The seven operations are there in all. The first one is opcode fetch. In this, opcode is we already discussed, but again I am covering this here. Opcode means operation code, which operation microprocessor is going to perform, the operation code. Like addition or copying, any arithmetic or logical operation, or which operation microprocessor is going to perform. So for that we had for each operation we have one opcode. This operation code is fetched by microprocessor, and depending on that opcode, the further machine cycle will be performed by the microprocessor. So each instruction consists of an opcode and the operand. Second machine cycle is memory read. In this machine cycle, microprocessor is going to read a data from memory. We know that microprocessor has to perform some task and it needs the operand. That operand or data is either stored in a memory or it is taken from an input device. So if a microprocessor has to read the data from memory, then the machine operation is memory read. If after performing the task microprocessor wants to write the data, microprocessor wants means as a programmer we give instruction to microprocessor that store the result in the memory. So in that case, if we give a instruction that store the result in the memory, then in that case this machine cycle memory write will be performed by microprocessor. Then if microprocessor is reading the data from input device, whether it is keyboard or mouse, then in that case it is IO read operation. And if it is writing on a monitor or printer, then it is an IO write operation. The sixth machine operation, that is interrupt acknowledgement. Whenever any other peripheral device or wants to get any task done by microprocessor, then it will interrupt the microprocessor. So whenever a microprocessor is interrupted by some other device, external or hardware device, then in that case microprocessor send an interrupt acknowledgement that I acknowledge your interrupt and I am going to serve you. So in that case this interrupt cycle is this machine cycle is performed by microprocessor. There are some situation in which microprocessor has to keep idle. There are some instruction in which microprocessor just have to wait so that operation has to be performed by microprocessor internally. So for outside world microprocessor is in idle condition, but to show that idle condition the machine operation is bus idle. So there are in total seven machine operation that is performed by microprocessor, and each instruction must have one cycle, that is opcode fetch, and remaining are depending on the type of instruction, that whether that instruction is 1 byte or 2 byte or 3 byte, and whether this instruction is to get the data from memory or to give data to the memory. So depending on the instruction, next machine cycles are incorporated in that particular instruction. So whenever we give an instruction to microprocessor, that instruction needs some time to be executed. So the time taken by microprocessor to execute that instruction is instruction cycle, and each instruction cycle is composed of many machine cycle. and that are these seven machine cycles. We will see one by one. So before going to see the detail of opcode fetch and memory read and all these machine cycle, we will have a general description that how the status and control signals, what all signals are generated. So this status signal, this signal just give a user or the programmer the status of microprocessor. So this bits, when we see when we'll read it, these all are the output signals that are generated from microprocessor. So whenever microprocessor is going to fetch a opcode from memory, in that case, as it is working with memory, so zero signal is placed at this pin, S1 is 1 and S0 is 1. So 011 indicates that microprocessor is performing opcode fetch. 111 indicates that microprocessor is going to give a interrupt acknowledgement cycle is going to be performed by microprocessor. So whenever we see this status signal, we can predict that which operation is microprocessor is going to perform. Like if we read 001 on this three pins, then in that case we will predict that it is microprocessor is rewriting data into the memory. In case of halt, that is end of the program, this IO/M bar is Z, that is it a high impedance state, neither 0 nor 1, it is in high impedance state, and S1 and S0 is 00. This situation indicates that this is the end of program. Now microprocessor is not performing any task. If microprocessor the whole signal is generated by DMA, we see that hold is a request which is generated by direct memory controller, that is DMA, direct memory access controller. DMA generate hold signal to get the control of buses. So in that situation, microprocessor does not have buses in its control, it releases buses control to the DMA. So in that case, the status is Z, that is high impedance state. And don't care, because why don't care, because S1 and S0, it is the status and microprocessor is not performing any task, so we are not able to predict that which what is going on. So in that case, it is either it may be 00, it may be 01 10 11, but this high impedance state indicate that it is in hold state. In case of reset, again this is the situation. Now, how we can differentiate whether microprocessor is performing opcode fetch or memory read or write? So then again we have a control signal. So when this control signal, whenever microprocessor is reading some data, read signal is active low. Okay, these three operations. When microprocessor is writing something, then write signal is active low. Okay, so it depends which operation is going to reading, read signal is active low, writing, write signal is active low. Okay, and in case microprocessor is going to have an interrupt acknowledgement, then the signal is active low. A rest of the time it will be active high, because microprocessor is not interrupted. So microprocessor is interrupted only for interrupt acknowledgement signal is generated, then in that case it is 0, and these two are at high impedance state, because neither microprocessor is reading something nor it is writing something. Now these are some signals that I am going to discuss, because we have to see the timing machine cycle, so timing operation. So how we are going to represent the signal. So I already told you that microprocessor is a digital programmable device which will be synchronized using clock. So how we are going to represent a clock signal? So I think all of you are aware that we use square wave to represent a clock. So this total T on and T off period is T state, that is one clock cycle. This is the ideal situation, but practically we don't have this perfect square wave. We have some rise time, and some fault time. So this is some rise time. So microprocessor, you know, clock circuit generator needs some time to get rise to a top level. So this rise time and fault time we have to indicate, and now we have a T state from this fault state to next fault state. So this is one TF. Okay. So practically we will represent our clock in this manner. Then if we have to represent a signal, when I am drawing a timing diagram, say for any machine operation, then I have to represent some signals, whether read operation or whether write signal or ALE, any electrical signal that is generated by microprocessor. So in that case, we use this type of representation. We have to this represent logic 0 and this is logic 1, and this is rise time and this is fall time. Now if we are going to represent the group of signal, that is whether we are going to represent status signal or we have to represent our address bus, then in that case we will use this type of representation, a group of signal. Okay. In case of single signal, whether I am have to represent ALE or read bar or write bar, then in that case this is the single way representation. So this is the representation of our signals. Now how we are going to get the timing diagram for any machine operation? So what all the steps to draw the timing diagram? So first and foremost step is we have to draw the clock signal. Then with clock we have to draw the ALE signal, that is address latch enable signal. Okay, ALE is an active high signal. It will be active high for first T1 clock. So for each machine cycle, first T1 clock ALE is high. What it indicates, ALE address latch enable, the signal indicates that the multiplexed address and data lines will carry the address, lower order address line, means it behaves like a lower order address line. So address latch enable signal, ALE signal, is used to latch the lower order address in an address bus. In step 2, we are going to draw the address and data line. So address and data lines are merged, and they are merged in a way that AD0 to AD7. So here we represent it at AD0 to AD7, and in first T1 clock cycle only the lower order address is traveling. So we represent it like this. So in this case it represented that multiplexed address and data line carries only lower order address. Suppose we have to transfer 3000 H. Then in that case 00 is traveling in T1 time cycle, because 00 is lower order address, we can say AL, and 30 is higher order address. So in step 3 we are going to represent the address with data. So in that case for T1 cycle address is traveling, T2 we will have some high impedance state, and in T3 we will place the data. This is the case of read operation, because microprocessor send address to the memory, and from memory it will takes the data. So it will wait for memory to write the data on the data bus. But in the case when microprocessor is performing write operation, in that case data is available with microprocessor only. So after address it will place the data on the data bus. So this is the difference between the read operation and the writing operation. Then we have to draw the higher order address lines, so A8 to A15. So for this for all the three T states we will have A8 to A15. T4 state is in high impedance. This line stated that it is a high impedance side state. बिकॉज माइक्रोप्रोसेसर हैज़ टू वेट फॉर मीन्स माइक्रोप्रोसेसर इज परफॉर्मिंग सम टास्क सो दिस टास्क हैज़ टू बी लाइक ऑपकोड इज डिकोडेड और इट हैज़ टू प्लेस सम डेटा फ्रॉम डेटा बस टू सम इंटरनल रजिस्टर सो वी विल गिव वन क्लॉक साइकिल फॉर द ऑपरेशन ऑफ डिकोडिंग और प्लेसिंग अ डेटा फ्रॉम डेटा बस टू इंटरनल मेमोरी एंड इन स्टेप फाइव we are going to write about the status. So first machine cycle for every instruction the first machine cycle will be opcode fetch. How we are representing opcode fetch? IO slash M bar will be 0, S naught will be 1, S1 will be 1. Means whenever S naught and S1 will be 1 and IO slash M bar is 0, it indicates a fetch operation is going to be performed. In read operation, in case of memory read, this will be 0, S0 will be 0 and S1 will be 1. So, 001 indicates memory read operation. So, first machine operation if it is opcode fetch, second will be memory read or memory write or IO read, IO write. It depends on the instruction. Then, step 6 where we are going to draw about the read and write operation. So as the first operation is memory read operation because opcode fetch. Fetching means reading a opcode operation code from the memory. So in that case read signal will be active low. Now here you can see that we are making read signal active low in T2 state. Why we are doing this? Because in T1 state, we are only placing the address on address bus. Microprocessor is placing our address on address bus at T1 time cycle. So, this address will reach to the memory and by the time it reaches to the memory, the read signal is active low indicates that microprocessor is reading our data from memory. And in case if we have to write the data, then also microprocessor will make this write signal active low in T2 state only because in first state, microprocessor is placing the address on the address bus. So, let's see how microprocessor is performing the task in case of opcode fetch operation. What all, this is the architecture part of microprocessor and this is the timing diagram. So, first of all, we will draw the clock signal, then we will draw the higher order address line, then lower order address line which is multiplexed with AD data lines, then ALE, status signal and read signal. Because in opcode fetch, only read operation is performing, write signal is active high, so you can draw a straight line representing a write signal. So, it is not required. So, it is omitted here. So, how it is going to perform? So, whenever microprocessor has to start opcode fetching, microprocessor plays a data address of program counter on address bus. So, in T1 time cycle, address is placed here, lower, active low. Okay. We will always work with falling time. Okay, so in at this time a new address is traveling, higher order address. Okay, and same time a lower order address is also placed because address line multiplex address line and data lines are working as an address line and ALE signal is high. Now it will become low from T2, T3 and T4 state. Now address is placed. Then there is some high impedance state from here and then an opcode is read from the memory. So, this time is not known to us because opcode is placed by memory on the data bus so that this high impedance state is not microprocessor has to wait that memory has to the data has to be read given by the memory. Okay. By the time this opcode is placed on the address data bus, that is multiplexed data lines, T4 time is the time taken by microprocessor so that this data which is available here, the opcode that is available here, it goes to instruction register, and instruction register then stores this opcode, decode it, and after this, for this decoding time, this is the T4 time. So nothing is specified at the memory at the timing cycle. In case of read operation, again microprocessor plays a date address from where microprocessor has to read the data. ALE signal is high. AD0 to AD7 line is carrying the address line, then status signal and read signal is active low, and this data is placed from the memory. So again, we are not means microprocessor has to wait for some time so that memory will place the data on the data bus. Now this data which is traveling to the microprocessor through this data line, it will be not going to be decoded, it will be saved in this memory location. So we don't require any T4 state. So the time taken by opcode fetch is 4 T state. And time taken by memory read is 3 T state. Okay. In case of memory write, the difference between memory read and memory write is only you can see here only that data, in this case data is placed by microprocessor only, so it will place the data just into T2 state only. It has no need to wait for that because data is with microprocessor. And write signal is active low. So in case of memory write, again 3 T state is required, 3 clock cycle are required, but in this case data is placed just after the at the beginning of T2 state. In case of IO read, the address actually in case of 8085, the input output device address is from 00 to FF. Only 256 input output device we can access through microprocessor 8085. So in that case, the higher order address line and lower order address line both carry the same data because we need only 8-bit address. So both carries the same data at the same time. The difference lies here again in the status signal. Here IO/mbar will be 1. In case of memory read, this value is 0. In case of IO read, this value is 1. You can see S1 and S0 will be S1 and 1 and 0. And in case of IO write, that is write operation is performed. Again A8 and A5 AD0 carry same address. Write signal is active, and here you can also see that as the T2 is active low, the data is from microprocessor is placed on the data bus. So this is all about the machine operation which is going to be performed. The next machine operation that is interrupt acknowledgement. The 5 machine operation that we had seen, all they depending on the instruction, we have a combination of all of them. For example, in case of MVI A,34H, we have first opcode fetch cycle, and then we have to read the data from memory. So second one is the memory read. Okay, so for this instruction, first is opcode fetch, then memory read. In case of move A,B, we have only opcode fetch. In case of LXI B,3000H, we have one opcode fetch OF, two memory read, because first we have to read 00, then we have to read 30. So two read operation. So depending on which instruction we are going to perform, microprocessor will have a combination of opcode fetch, memory read, IO write, IO read. For example, if in 40H. So here first is opcode fetch, and then IO read operation is going to perform. In case of an interrupt is generated by any other device, then in that case microprocessor is going to give an interrupt acknowledgement signal. So in that case, this is the machine operation that microprocessor is going to perform. First machine operation is opcode fetch, or you can say it is not a opcode fetch machine cycle. In this case, the content of program counter is stored to the stack. So that whenever that interrupt is service routine is fulfilled, that interrupt service routine is completed, microprocessor will come back and serve the main program. So in that case, we have to store our content of program counter onto the stack. So for that case, we will use this address lines and data lines so that we can transfer the control from main program to the interrupt service routine. So in that case, we have to write a data from address bus to the stack, that is content of program counter has to be transferred from program counter to the stack, and the content of program counter is reloaded. Okay, so for that, how we are going to perform, the address bus, higher order address bus and lower order address bus, that in that case carry the content of stack pointer, not the content of program counter. The content of program counter is considered as a data in case of interrupt acknowledgement case. In case of call instruction, the first machine operation is the case where opcode is fetched for corresponding to call. So first is opcode fetch, then second data means, if for example I have an instruction call 3A00H. So first this opcode fetch 6T state here, because microprocessor has to store the content of program counter to the stack. So in this case, you can see, in case this is a special case, that in case of first machine operation opcode fetch, in case of call instruction, it is B of T6T states, and microprocessor has to place a content of program counter onto the stack. Then this 00 and A0 is read. So first 00 is read, then A0 is read, and this data is 3A is read by the microprocessor, and then this data is placed on the address bus as an address, and from there the data will be fetched. So in case of interrupt acknowledgement cycle, we have 6 for call state, we have 5 machine operation. Now in case of DAD instruction, DAD is an instruction which indicate microprocessor that it has to perform a addition between an HL pair and DE pair, 16 bit addition. So in that case, microprocessor only has to fetch a opcode. So only the first machine operation, that is opcode fetch, will be done, T4 state. The opcode of DAD is fetched, but then addition has to be performed. And to perform that 16 bit addition, microprocessor needs 6 T states. And for this particular 6 T states, microprocessor will be considered as an ideal case, because microprocessor is performing all the tasks internally. It is adding the content of HL with DE internally. So it is not working with outside world. So in that case, we feel that it is an ideal state, but not it is an idle state, it is performing the addition operation in its internal register, with its internal register. So it needs a 6 T state time to perform this addition operation. So in that case, you can say that for DAD instruction, we need 10 T states, 4 for opcode fetch and 6 as an idle state. But for remaining, like if I do add B, so in add B, we need only 40 states. That is for opcode fetch only. In case of TRAP, that is the highest priority interrupt, which is a non-maskable interrupt. So whenever TRAP signal is generated, if for any clock cycle, for suppose it is generated for T3 clock of any opcode fetch, microprocessor will perform that particular task, particular opcode fetch machine operation. Then with that next cycle, the control is transferred, that is microprocessor data will be stored, program counter content will be stored on the stack pointer, and a new value is assigned to the program counter, that is the 00H, and it will move to the ideal state, that is restart condition, because TRAP is used to be used whenever there is some malfunctioning occur and it is having an highest priority. So in that case, it will shift from the current execution of the program to a new location. So in that case, the program counter value has to be stored on the stack pointer. So this is all about TRAP. And in case of wait state, that whenever microprocessor has any ready signal or NOP operation, then in that case neither microprocessor is reading something from memory, neither writing something. In case of wait state, microprocessor has to wait that so that it can get some data from the memory. So for that wait state, whenever the state wait state is inserted, the duration will be increased, the reading and writing operation time is increased, and so that microprocessor has to get delayed, so that from so any slow peripheral, if suppose our keyboard is slowly converted some data, then in that case this ready signal is activated by microprocessor and the keyboard controller, and the keyboard controller send microprocessor this instruction so that it can wait for my keyboard controller to release the data. Okay, so the read operation is performed with some delay. So a T wait state is inserted, and now the wait state, how many wait state we can insert, it again depend on the speed, what is the speed of the keyboard controller and what is the speed of the microprocessor which we are going to interface. So this is all about machine operation. We have discussed different machine operation. In next lecture, I am going to discuss about the instruction set and further programming related to 8085. Thank you.